Yes, sir.
Well, I just saw an ad on TV where the controlling party wants to give these tax excess taxes back, saying, well, wouldn't everybody like to get $134 back, and you could spend it on whatever you want? Well, yeah, I could go in and get my front end realigned, or I could maybe repair some of the tires and wheels that have been destroyed by potholes. But I think it's kind of ironic that one party wants to give back excesses and look good to the voters and then not pay for anything or not do anything with what they have until they run the economy into a deficit. And then they turn it over to the other party, and we finally repair all the deficits and get it all fixed, and we try to make some headway on repairing bridges and roads and infrastructure, which has been neglected for the last 20 years. And now they want to give the money back that they finally got. And it's like the guy sitting on the porch fiddling away in the sunlight, and the guy comes by and says, well, I thought your roof had a hole in it. Well, yeah, but it's not raining, so why would I work on it? It just doesn't make any sense.
Back in the corner there, and then over to Dr. Anderson.
I'm having a real hard time with that comment because, frankly, the budget for the state has gone up every year, despite the fact that there was all the whining that went on about how it was cut back so much, which was merely a cutback in the rate of growth. You increased the taxes, what was it, $3 billion a couple of years ago? Now you're talking about another, was it $6 billion in the next biennium from
he was proposing over 10 years. A system that would raise $6 billion over 10 years.
Okay. The point is, the taxes keep going up year after year. I'm sorry, my salary doesn't go up that fast. Get some kind of proportion in your comments, for crying out loud.
Well, the party...
We're starting to deviate a little bit from where we're supposed to be on the transportation.
Let's stick to transportation.